in Bangkok, Thailand. It's beyond me. I think the fact lies in the George Bush, our vice president now, was in fact head of the CIA in 1975. It's just prime time for all this covert operation financed by drugs. If George Bush did not know about it, he's incompetent. If he did know about it, even worse, he's culpable. George Bush has further strengthened Mr. Armitage's position in the Pentagon by appointing Mr. Carlucci now as Secretary of Defense. Carlucci was the close associate of George Bush in the CIA. I think as Americans, we need to think very seriously about our responsibilities to this country. Back to what JFK said. That's not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. Many people, some of my friends, have expressed concern that my life may be in danger. I don't think my life is worth much when you live with the potential harm that might occur to this country if something is done about this. The U.S. Congress obviously is going out on its own. Danny Sheehan says that he cannot attack Mr. Armitage directly because as soon as he tries, as a source of national security, the fall of the whole state, and he'll be prevented in the discovery phase from getting to the truth. Right now, though, he does have a lawsuit going against General Singlot, against Hines, Shackley, Secord, and those others that have been involved with the CIA since 1965. That's who he's heard in Miami, Florida.
This is one. government for illegally trafficking in drugs for covert operations.